Yoga. My name is Michelle. Thank you for joining me. Today I do have, for modifications, I do have a blanket and I do have two blocks. You don't have to have them. A pillow will be fine. Something that if you do need a little cushion or space, this is a good class for that. So I'm just going to place these here to the side at first, but if you want to just grab something real quick. So we're going to start in this comfortable seat. You can sit cross-legged or out. I will try to show you every modification I can think of. So listen to your own body. If you don't like something at all, don't do it. Just rest. You can be in child's pose. And if this is your first practice, either with me or ever on your mat, or maybe you are literally starting from scratch and you're on your carpet, I want you to take a slow deep breath. Focus on centering that mind and just really calming all that craziness between your ears. Relax your shoulders away from your ears. Take a deep cleansing breath. I want you to inhale, feel your chest expand. And as you exhale, just feel it contract back down and exhale anything that's stressing you out, anything that you're holding in, any of that fear, doubt, or maybe just something from your past you're not super sure. Just exhale real loud and let it go. Let's do that again. Inhale. Exhale. And if you'd like to imagine you're here with me out in this beautiful setting, you can hear the stream, the creek, you can smell the fresh air, the grass and the pine trees. And as you exhale, just visualize yourself wherever it is you want to be and let yourself go. We're going to start by rolling those shoulders. Today we're going to be working on plow pose, child's pose. We're going to be working on camel mostly, and then take it ear to shoulder. The only danger of being under these pine trees is that you never know if one's going to fall, and I'm super scared when you start hearing something click. So far one hasn't fallen on me, but I definitely ducked for cover. And then round the shoulders, tuck your chin into your chest, massaging through that throat, creating circulation right through that thyroid, opening up the back of the neck. We're going to need to open the back of the neck for that plow pose. Hold it right here. So everything is going to be a progression to our camel pose and our plow pose. Inhale. Very lightly lift your chin up to your chest, chin up to the sky. Now, if it bothers you to have your head back, I'll show you options as you go. You'll keep your neck completely neutral. And if you'd like, take your jaw and extend it forward. Just really stretch right through that mandible. Release the jaw, let it go, super heavy. And then take it down, chin to chest again, massaging the back of the neck, rock back and forth. Just tilting it, chin over to each side. And then hold it center, keep your spine nice and tall. Inhale, neutral spine, roll your shoulders back. Open your heart. Now as you open your heart, squeeze your shoulder blades together. We're gonna work on this in our camel, so open up, turn your palms out. Inhale, notice the stretch even through the biceps, the chest, the shoulders. Open and then lift and hold it here. Shine your heart bright. And as you shine your heart and your forehead bright, feel that chin and chest lifting, not just back, but up. More importantly, up. And then slowly round and then slowly come down. If your legs are crossed, that's fine. Round your back and drop down. Blocks here if you need them. So you can rest on your blocks here. You can rest on your blocks here. Just feel that back and shoulders opening up. Slowly come on up. Let's switch legs. If your legs were crossed, cross them the other way. Even if it feels a little awkward, round and drop back down.
Open up that spine.
Slowly release and shake it out. We're going to flip over into our child's pose. So in our child's pose, we're going to open our knees wide. Start by opening the hips, lengthening the spine.
Knees are wide, toes to touch. Extend your arm. Now, if it bothers your arms, just bend your elbows. Shift your hips back towards your heels. Take a deep breath. Let your chest and your armpits fall to the earth. Now, as we open up the shoulders in order to get into that camel pose, lift up halfway and place your elbows on the earth and place your palms in prayer. And this is not religious, it's all just a word right here with our hands and you're going to go ahead, sit back, and rest your hands behind your back. Press your elbows forward so the triceps are sitting on the earth, and push your armpits in. Feel that stretch right through the armpits and the back. Slowly release. Shift your weight forward onto your forearms. Use those hands to lift yourself up into your tabletop, round the back. Now this is going to help with our plow. Tuck your chin in as deep as you can and hold it there. Exhale, drop your belly. It's going to help with our camel. Press your shoulder blades back. Open that heart again. Lift that chin and chest up and forward. Exhale, one more cat, round the back. This time really imagine those shoulder blades separating from your spine and your chin really tucking into your chest. Exhale, drop your belly. Oh, the sun is coming out. It's absolutely gorgeous. Neutral spine, shake it out. So we're going to come into a little hero's pose. We're stretching through the feet. If you don't like this in your knees, this is where those blocks and your blanket come in handy. So if you want, and it's a pillow is fine too, you'll take it here and you'll just sit right down in your blanket or your pillow. But what this does is create space so there's not as much in the knee. But it feels so fabulous. You can even stretch out those feet. It feels so good on the front of your ankles. Yes? Good. All right, so from here, hands and heart center. You can always come on up. Take a breath. Just hold it here. We're going to place those hands on our lower back. Now use your thumbs or your full back. So either, let me show you. You can either have your thumbs on your low back or place your hands on your low back here. And that just depends on the flexibility of your shoulders. All right? So we're right here. Very lightly bring your elbows back, belly button in, and open your heart. Now you don't have to go real far. We're going to start working on our camel pose, elbows back. This is a modified camel's pose. Elbows back. We want to make sure our spine is neutral so you don't have to bring your head all the way back. And right here, I'm going to show you multiple versions of camel pose. This is camel pose number one. Squeeze your glutes to support. It's not about how far you go back. It's about lifting that heart up. Slowly release. Inhale, take your time as you sit down into your heels just to neutral that spine. And again, you can have your blanket. I'm going to grab my blocks to show you. So go ahead and take your blocks one on each side. If you don't have blocks, that's fine. Water bottles work. But this is the next section to our camel. You can have them high or low, close to your feet. Now here's another deal. You can either have your feet flat or bring your toes curl so that you can reach into your heels. So you choose. So for now, I'm going to have my toes flat. Inhale, we're going to start with one arm up. Exhale, take your left hand behind you to support your back. Reach, remember we're going up. Exhale, hand on your block and open up. So that hand is close to your foot or on your heel. You can have your left hand up. So we're not leaning into the foot, you're pushing off. And that's where those heels lifted up can help you lift up. So come out of this, hands on that low back. Inhale, center. Take your time. Feel free to sit down. So this is great for circulation through your spine and through your heart. We're going to do the other side. I'm going to curl those toes, bringing the earth closer to me. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, this time, left hand on your block or on your heels. Reach. And you can have your hand on your back. Reach. Remember, we're reaching up. And then push away from your foot. Slowly lifting up. Take your time. Sit down into your hero's pose if you'd like. Take a breath and just let yourself go so you can feel all that circulation through your neck, your spine. And if anything bothers you, please, please do not do it. You can always keep your head straight. We'll go back to our first position in our camel's pose. So now we're going to try both arms. So you can have your blocks so they're closer and then grab on those. You can grab onto your heels or drop your feet. Remember, we're pushing up, so we want support on the back. Let's place the hands here. I'm going to use my toes curled. Gives me a better base as well. Inhale, raise up. Squeeze your glutes, support your back. Drop down. And then once you find it, we want to roll our shoulder blades up.
a very long time, this was all I could do. And that's fine. Everybody's different. If this bothers your neck, keep your head neutral. Slowly to come out of it, hands on your lower back. Super slow. Flatten the toes. Take a breath, sit into your hero's pose. Can you feel that? We're gonna work on our plow pose, which is our reverse stretch. For now, very slowly, walk your hands. Knees are gonna be together and extend back down into your child's pose, lengthening the spine. So our camel pose, we're opening our heart, our shoulders, our chest. And that bend in our back is really good for it as well. Massaging through all the vertebrae. But again, please modify. Our back is always really tight, so bending it is gonna be a little bit harder. And slowly lift yourself up. One cat-cow, round your back. Exhale, drop your belly. Neutral spine, shake it out. Can you feel all that space in that spine? Let your head hold heavy. And slowly come to a comfortable seat. Now before we go into our plow, let's take just a moment to reset and remind ourselves that everything is a journey. And some days we have really strong, powerful days, motivating days. Then some days we're just like, I need to lay down. I need to just reset. So whatever that is for you today, tomorrow, just take it for what it is. It's okay. It's completely normal. So we're going to lay on our backs. So the reverse of that would be a plow pose. There's plenty of others, but today I'm showing you a plow pose. Very slowly load down and lay down. Now, this is fine. If you want to stay here and rock back and forth, please feel free to stay here. This is yoga. Exhale, legs extended, savasana, arms reach to stretch. Exhale, arms at your side, savasana. Here is yoga, so if you need to be here and you're done with your practice today, that's completely fine. We're gonna work on plow pose. Now I'm gonna show you some options in plow pose. You've gotta use those abs a little bit. Plow pose number one. We start with our knees hugged in. And this is completely fine, but a plow pose opens up the neck as well. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna push our hands into the earth, and if you need to kick your legs up, you can. We're gonna push. I like to use my hands. So I'm gonna use my hands to push, and this is fine. You can have your knees covered. You can have your legs up. You can have them here, or slowly. Now if it's too much on your neck, please don't do it. Use your hands on your back. Make sure you're not looking to the right or left. Now if you want, you can have your arms down. You can turn your toes. Or maybe you want to work on bringing your legs up. The weight is on your shoulders and the back of your neck, or the back of your head, not your neck. Still working on trying to get my legs all the way up. Now when you come down, super slow, one vertebrae at a time. And I like to lift my head up a little first, kind of release it, drop the knees, slowly let your head fall, slowly let your legs fall, and take a breath. So there's your plow pose. Take a breath, we'll lengthen. We're gonna do it one more time, your choice, if you wanna just hug your knees into the chest. This is a more advanced pose, but there's options for everybody. And everybody starts in a different position. So some people think plow pose is the easiest thing ever. Some people have a harder time. Now, if you're bigger chested and everything is just pushing into your face here, take a breath, push them down, all right? And you're gonna open your knees a little bit wider. So if you're a little bit fuller through the front area, knees wider. So we're gonna take a breath. You can start here, and if you want, just stay right here. This is fine. This stretches out your back too. Inhale, and you can have your knees wider. That is the one issue I don't have. But my booty is big. That's why I like to hold it up, because I feel like it rolls it down. Option
chin to lift up. The weight is on the shoulders and the back of the head, not on the neck. Still working on trying to get those legs all the way up. Everything is a journey. Slowly lower, one vertebrae at a time. So I'm going to keep my head down. Ooh, hug the knees. Take your time. Open your knees wide. Let your shoulders rest on the earth. Take a second. If you need anything else, maybe child's pose. Extend those legs all the way. Arms all the way. Stretch everything. Open that rib cage. Inhale. Exhale and release. So today we worked on camel pose, plow pose, the progression to warm up that spine, chest and shoulders. Focusing on our breath. So I have a multitude of beginner yoga classes all focusing on different things. So if you're interested in some more beginner yoga classes or gentle yoga classes, all working on mind, body, focus, spirit. And taking these practices off our mat, challenging ourselves, yet giving us the permission to make mistakes and to have those days where we just need to reset. Feel free to stay in Savasana or roll over onto one side, hugging your knees into your chest, especially if you just did your camel and your plow. This feels really good. Just let your head rest right on that bottom arm. Relax your face. So holding that tension in your face, your eyebrows, your forehead, just keeps that stress in. We just want to let it go. Use that top arm to push yourself into a seated position. Remember, you can always, always do this at your own time, hands and heart center. If you have any questions, please feel free to message me. I'm here for you. I'd love to connect with you, show you the modifications you need, even if it's to increase the intensity, lower the intensity. I specialize in injuries and working with middle-aged women that just need to refocus, recenter, just like me. Every day is a journey. Thank you so much for joining me. If you'd like more classes, please click the link in the bio. The badass in me honors the badass in you. Namaste.